Hi, this is Dr. Vijay. Today we are going to study about various factors influencing the rate of enzyme-catalyzed reaction. There are many factors which affect enzyme activity, but we are discussing some of the important factors today. The first factor which influences enzyme activity is substrate concentration, which we already discussed in the previous video. The second factor, the concentration of enzyme itself. The third factor which influences velocity of enzyme reaction is hydrogen ion concentration or pH. And the last factor we will be discussing today is temperature. Apart from these four factors, there are many other factors also, like effect of products, effect of inhibitors, activators. So we will be discussing these inhibitors or activators and products under enzyme inhibition and enzyme regulation. So the first factor we already discussed in the previous video. In this video, we are discussing effect of enzyme concentration, pH and temperature on the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction. In other words, enzyme activity. So here we will see the effect of varying concentration of enzymes on the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction. In the x-axis, we have enzyme concentration, the different enzyme concentration, and the y-axis is velocity or rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction. So you can see, as the enzyme concentration increases, there is linear increase in the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction. So we can say velocity is directly proportional to the concentration of enzyme. Here you need to remember, this rate is directly proportional as long as the substrate concentration is adequate. That means in this particular reaction there should be sufficient or adequate amount of substrates. As long as substrate concentration is sufficient, the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of enzyme. So this property, this kinetic property, can be used to find out levels of enzymes in different tissues or plasma or serum or tissues. Suppose you want to find out particular enzyme level in the tissues and in the blood. So we can incubate this sample which contains the enzyme and incubate with sufficient amount of substrate, and this reaction should be carried out for a fixed time, and because of enzyme present in the sample it will give product, and we can measure this product. Then we can compare the amount of products in serum, the amount of product in plasma, or amount of product in some other body fluids or tissues. Because the amount of product formed is directly proportional to amount of enzyme present in the particular sample. So we can make use of this kinetic property to find out levels of same enzymes in different samples. So the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction is directly proportional to amount of enzymes or enzyme concentration, provided sufficient or adequate substrate concentration is there. Now we will see what is the effect of pH on the enzyme activity. You can see here, as the pH increases, the activity of enzyme increases, and then there is a point where the activity of enzyme or the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction is maximum. Thereafter If you go on increase the pH, the rate of enzyme catalyzed reactions goes on decreasing. So this curve is called bell-shaped curve. As usual, y-axis is the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction, whereas x-axis is the pH. The activity of this particular enzyme is maximum at this point, and this point is called optimum pH. Every enzyme has got their own optimum pH. That means optimum pH is different for different enzymes. And below this optimum pH or above this optimum pH, the activity of enzyme is decreased. Most of enzyme present in our body has got optimum pH between 6 to 8. But there are few enzymes, their optimum pH may be different. For example, if you take pepsin, which is present in the stomach, it has got optimum pH between 1 to 2. Similarly, trypsin, which is released from the pancreas to the duodenum, its optimum pH is around 8. Alkaline phosphatase, optimum pH is between 9 to 10. Acid phosphatase, between 4 to 5. So that means different enzyme has got their own optimum pH. So the optimum pH is where the enzyme activity is maximum, or rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction is maximum. Why there is a bell shaped curve here? Why the activity of enzyme on either side of optimum pH is less? Because we know that all enzymes are proteins, and proteins has got three-dimensional structure or conformation. And enzymes being a protein, they have active sites and they are made up of amino acids. As we know, amino acids are charged. So any alteration in the pH will lead to alteration of ionization state of the amino acids of enzymes. Ionization of amino acids present in the active site. Not only ionization of amino acids, also sometimes substrate also. If substrate being a protein, then definitely alteration in the pH will change the substrate ionization state also. And enzymes being a protein, if you subject these enzymes to extreme pH on either side of optimum pH, then this enzyme undergo denaturation. So that means disruption of secondary, tertiary and quaternary structure of the protein or enzymes. So they will lose their biological activity and they cannot catalyze any reactions. Sometimes extreme pH also dissociate prosthetic group from apoenzyme. So the effect of pH, every enzyme has got their own optimum pH where the enzyme activity is maximum. On either side, the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction decreases because of ionization state alteration, either active sites or sometimes substrate also. And on an extreme pH from the optimum pH, there may be chances of denaturation of enzymes because enzymes are proteins. And there may be possibility of dissociation of prosthetic group, cofactors or coenzymes or metal ions from apoenzyme. Effect of temperature. So here also we can see, as the temperature increases, the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction is increased and a point is reached. So this point we can call it as optimum temperature. So in the x-axis we have increase in the temperature. As usual, in the y-axis we have velocity. And you can see here, this particular enzyme has got maximum activity at this temperature. So this temperature is called optimum temperature. So every enzyme has got their own optimum temperature. So the effect of temperature is also a bell-shaped curve. Most of the enzyme present in our body, their optimum temperature is around 37 degree centigrade. That is our body temperature. And here one thing you need to remember, as the temperature is decreasing or as the temperature is increasing on either side of optimum temperature, enzymes are inactive. That is, on extreme side of optimum temperature, enzymes are inactive. But if temperature is below the optimum temperature, enzyme is inactive, but this inactivity is reversible. So this we can make use of storage of enzymes. Usually enzymes can be stored minus 20 degree centigrade to minus 70 degree centigrade. So when they brought back to optimum temperature, so they can catalyze any reactions. But as the temperature increases, they become inactive, and this inactivity cannot be brought back because the extreme temperature or high temperature makes enzymes denatured. So when the temperature goes above 50 degree centigrade, there will be disruption of secondary, tertiary and quaternary structure of proteins or enzymes. So it cannot be reversed. But as the temperature decreases, we can store these enzymes for longer duration for enzyme studies. So this is with respect to factors influencing enzyme activity. So effect of substrate concentration we already studied in the previous presentation. So in this presentation we studied effect of enzyme concentration, effect of pH and effect of temperature. So there are other factors which we will discuss under enzyme inhibition and enzyme regulation. Thanks for watching.